evening and welcome to Messiah Episcopal Church's Tuesday evening worship music and Compline, recorded here at Messiah in the sanctuary. Two themes will guide our worship this evening: Indigenous Peoples Day, which was yesterday, and also today's gospel reading with its two profound stories of healing. We begin with an opening prayer, a confession, and prayers for healing provided by the Office of Native Ministries of the Episcopal Church and also from Church of the Apostles Episcopal in Seattle, Washington. We will then continue with sung prayer and praise as usual, closing with Compline. There is a PDF document with the songs and Compline liturgy in a link in the description below this video. Let's begin with a moment of silence to center ourselves in God's presence. Light and peace in Jesus Christ our Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Creator, we give you thanks for all that you are and all that you bring to us within your creation. In Jesus, you placed the gospel in the center of the sacred circle through which all creation is related. You show us the way to live a generous and compassionate life. Give us strength to live together with respect and commitment as we grow in your spirit, for you are God now and forever. Amen. O gracious light, Lord Jesus Christ, in you the Father's glory shone. Immortal, holy, blessed is he, and blessed are you, his holy Son. Now sunset comes, but light shines forth. The lamps are lit to pierce the night. Praise Father, Son, and Spirit God, who dwells in the eternal light. Worthy are you of endless praise, O Son of God, life-giving Lord. Therefore you are through all the highest heaven adored. The gospel reading for today comes from Luke chapter 8, beginning at verse 40. Now when Jesus returned, the crowd welcomed him, for they were all waiting for him. Just then there came a man named Jairus, a leader of the synagogue. He fell at Jesus' feet and begged him to come to his house, for he had an only daughter about 12 years old who was dying. As he went, the crowds pressed in on him. Now there was a woman who had been suffering from hemorrhages for 12 years, and though she had spent all she had on physicians, no one could cure her. She came up behind him and touched the fringe of his clothes, and immediately her hemorrhage stopped. Then Jesus asked, "Who touched me?" When all denied it, Peter said, "Master, the crowds surround you and press in on you." But Jesus said, "Someone touched me, for I noticed that power had gone out from me." When the woman saw that she could not remain hidden, she came trembling and falling down before him. She declared in the presence of all the people why she had touched him and how she had been immediately healed. He said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace." While he was still speaking, someone came from the leader's house to say, "Your daughter is dead. Do not trouble the teacher any longer." When Jesus heard this, he replied, "Do not fear. Only believe, and she will be saved." When he came to the house, and he did not allow anyone to enter with him except Peter, John, and James, and the child's father and mother, they were all weeping and wailing for her, but he said, "Do not weep, for she is not dead, but sleeping." And they laughed at him, knowing that she was dead. But he took her by the hand and called out, "Child, get up." Her spirit returned, and she got up at once. Then he directed them to give her something to eat. Her parents were astounded, but he ordered them to tell no one what had happened. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I invite you to take a moment to reflect on the gospel reading that you just heard. Is there a word or a phrase that catches your imagination? Perhaps you sense Jesus saying something to you through these stories of healing. Perhaps there's an issue or an area of your life emerging in your thoughts just now in which you desire healing. Perhaps there's a societal issue or injustice that weighs on your heart this evening that is in need of healing. A word on today's themes. Personal healing is clearly evident in this reading, and I'm grateful to say that I've had many experiences of physical and emotional healing over the years in Christ. And I imagine many of you have as well. But there's also another element of healing that is on many of our hearts and minds, especially these days, and that is more societal or systemic healing, healing from injustice. Yesterday, much of this country still, after all these years, celebrated Columbus Day. It is no secret at this point that Columbus Day in 1492 was just the beginning of a terrible and brutal history of violence and oppression toward indigenous peoples of North America. Columbus and those who followed brought over disease, and the natives had no way to cure these, and ultimately desecrated entire peoples and cultures. This evening, we have an opportunity to acknowledge this history and to be honest about the ways our faith tradition has been used to colonize, abuse, and oppress people. And we seek to reclaim the truth of the gospel, that Christ came to love and to serve, not to conquer and enslave. With that in mind, let us open our hearts and confess together. O Great Spirit, God of every people and every tribe, we come to you as your many children to ask for your forgiveness and guidance. Forgive us for the colonialism that stains our past, the ignorance that allowed us to think that we could claim another's home for our own. Heal us of this history. Remind us that we are all gathered within the sacred circle of your community. Guide us through your wisdom to restore the truth of our heritage. Help us to confront the racism that divides us as we confess the pain it has caused the human family. Call us to kinship. Mend the hoop of our hearts and let us live in justice and peace through Jesus Christ, the one who came that all people might live in dignity. Amen. And now please join me in prayers for healing and hope. Let us now pray, recognizing brokenness suffered, wounds not yet healed, hope for peace and restoration. O Great Spirit, God of all people and every tribe, through whom all people are related, call us to the kinship of all your people. Grant us vision to see through the lens of justice the brokenness of the past. In your great love, O God, hear our prayers. Help us to listen to you and to one another in order to heal the wounds of the present, and give us courage, patience, and wisdom to work together for healing and hope with all of your people, now and in the future. In your great love, O God, hear our prayers. Mend the hoop of our hearts and let us live in justice and peace through Jesus Christ, the one who comes to all people, that we might live in dignity. Amen. During the music that follows, you are welcome to engage in one of the following prayer activities. You could write down or simply bring to mind prayers of lament for the brokenness of the past. These may be specific toward the injustice inflicted upon the indigenous peoples of North America or any other area of pain and brokenness that is on your heart today. If you have a home altar or prayer space or even a table or a bowl, you could place your written prayer in that special place. You could also write down or simply bring to mind prayers for healing and restoration. These may be specific, again, toward the injustice inflicted upon indigenous peoples of North America or any other area in need of God's healing and hope. These also could be placed on a home altar or table or special prayer place.
Christ is this world's peace. till false division cease, till enemies are reconciled, in Christ who is our peace, we are your healing love pour over this place, soothe the wounded soul. Let your healing love pour over this place, make your people whole. Jesus, your Spirit in us is a wellspring of life everlasting. Jesus, your Spirit in us is a wellspring of life everlasting. Jesus, your Spirit in us is a wellspring of life everlasting. Jesus, your Spirit in us is a wellspring of life everlasting. Jesus, your Spirit in us is a wellspring of life everlasting. Jesus, your Spirit in us is a wellspring of life everlasting.
Please join me in an order for Compline. The Lord Almighty grant us a peaceful night and a perfect end. Amen. Our help is in the name of the Lord, the Maker of heaven and earth. Let us confess our sins to God. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought and word and deed, and in what we have left undone. For the sake of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, forgive us all our offenses and grant that we may serve you in newness of life to the glory of your name. Amen. May the Almighty God grant us forgiveness of all our sins and the grace and comfort of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. In you, O Lord, have I taken refuge. Let me never be put to shame. Deliver me in your righteousness. Incline your ear to me. Make haste to deliver me. Be my strong rock, a castle to keep me safe. For you are my crag and my stronghold. For the sake of your name, lead me and guide me. Take me out of the net that they have secretly set for me. For you are my tower of strength. Into your hands I commend my spirit. For you have redeemed me, O Lord, O God of truth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Thanks be to God.
Fill our hearts with you.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. For you have redeemed me, O Lord, O God of truth. Keep us, O Lord, as the apple of your eye. Hide us under the shadow of your wings. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Lord, hear our prayer, and let our cry come to you. Be our light in the darkness, O Lord, and in your great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us pray together. Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night, and give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ. Give rest to the weary, bless the dying, soothe the suffering, pity the afflicted, shield the joyous, and all for your love's sake. Amen. I invite your intercessions and thanksgivings in the silence.
Waking, O Lord, and guard us sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace. Guide us waking, O Lord, and guard us sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep may rest in peace. Lord, you now have set your servant free to go in peace as you have promised. For these eyes of mine have seen the Savior, whom you have prepared for all the world to see, a light to enlighten the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Guide us waking, O Lord, and guard us sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace.
Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Almighty and merciful Lord, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless us and keep us. Amen.